That the first question is going to come from Greg Allman.
Hey, OJ, saw tight ends all over the place today in practice. So you, Gronk, Brate, even Eclair making big catches. How much do you get a sense in terms of the heightened role and the prominence that tight ends could play this year?
We definitely have, we're going to have an opportunity to make plays. You know, we got a room full of talent, mismatches, guys all over the board. So I think Coach and Byron are going to do a great job of just, you know, putting us in positions to make plays.
Okay, next up is Rick Stroud.
OJ, I know you spent a lot of time this summer at the Brooklyn Prep workouts with Tom. Just in your dealings with him, how much have you been able to learn and get chemistry with him during these practices?
You know, it started in the offseason, like you said, I just had an opportunity to work with him a couple times. But, you know, he does a lot of teaching, you know, and I think a lot of the guys and myself, we're all on the same page now, all because of some of the things that he teach. You know, he has certain things he likes to do on certain routes and how he likes them ran. And, you know, I think, you know, once we learned that with him and got down on the same chemistry, it's been going really well.
I noticed in watching Brady in practice, there were, when he'd throw the ball, it would go to the same spot like every single time. What's it like having a quarterback that's like that, and how can that help you?
You know, I think that's huge. You know, he like you said, he does a really good job of putting the ball in a spot, whereas, you know, I have an opportunity to make plays and run after the catch. You know, and that's something that we all have to do well as receivers, helping him when he asks for, like, certain things on routes, like as reducing them, certain routes and coming back to the ball. It all goes hand-in-hand with each other. It allows him to give us a great ball, allows us to allow the defender not to make a play on it. But it does help, and it's really helpful, you know, when he does that.
Next up's Ed Encina.
In a practice like this, what stands out about a Tom Brady directed, you know, offense in practice? Is it, you know, the pace? Is it where he puts the ball? Is it, you know, like you said, the teaching that he does? What makes it different?
I just think it's the whole overall intensity of the practice, you know, as far as the defense. I mean, these guys, they're pretty amped up going against Tom. They want to make a play on him. So it's real good competition for everyone across the board. You know, we get best coverages from our defenders, which allows us to get the best look we're going to get for the whole season. But like you said, every day when Tom comes out, he brings the intensity. He's a great leader. We come out to work, and I think we have had some solid days of practice so far.
All right, next up is Kevin O'Donnell.
Hey, OJ. You know, last year there was so much speculation midway through the season about you being traded. It kind of trickled into the offseason, and then they signed Rob Gronkowski. What was your reaction to all that, and what kind of conversations have you had with, Jason Light and Bruce Arians just about your future, because it appears, you know, you're still their guy?
Yeah, man, there's a lot of things going on with that. But right now, the biggest thing is, you know, I'm going to help this team win games. You know, that's just been the whole talk with me and Jason and everyone else around the building, you know, just coming in and playing my part and playing my role that I played last year. But as far as on a different role, making more plays and, you know, helping us to win games, that's the biggest thing for me right now. And it's been a really good start so far. You know, the offense has been coming smooth for myself and I think everyone else, because it's year two. So it's been really big strides made, and I'm just excited to get going.
What's Rob going to do for you in terms of just sharing some of his experience to help you reach that next level?
Oh, man, we've already made a lot of improvements in a lot of areas as far as he's helping us out a lot in the run game with footwork and, you know, just different things and routes that he used over the years to help him get open. You know, and just being on the field with him, you know, us together has been a big mismatch, and it's hard to, like, cover a lot of guys like that when we're on the field together. It's just hard to stop that. So, I mean, so it's going to open up a lot of things for everyone, and I think it should be real fun.
Is Luke Easterling.
OJ, I think a lot of, you know, people, whether it's fans or really anybody who follows the league at all, can get into this fantasy football mindset where if you don't see certain numbers in terms of production, you feel like someone's not really having an impact, but particularly at your position, which requires and asks so much in so many different ways of every player. You know, what, I guess, can you tell fans that maybe they don't know about specifically playing tight end and doing it at a high level that maybe just doesn't show up on your fantasy football box score?
You know, tight end is probably one of the toughest positions to play, because you have to do a little bit of everything, a little bit of blocking and, you know, pass catching and pass blocking also. So, but it's a lot of the dirty work that goes into it, man. I mean, you want to sometimes you have to block the best defense in, you know, in the run game. Then you gotta stop the best pass rusher in the pass game. So, I mean, but it comes with the game. It comes with the position. But it's a lot of dirty work that goes into it. You know, it's also fun to go out and catch touchdowns and catch passes, but it's way more to the position than just doing that. So a lot of fans kind of forget about that. But like I said, it's part of the game. It's part of the position. And, you know, it comes with it.
Next up is John Ledyard.
OJ, when Coach Arians met with us earlier today, he was mentioning that the tight end position in his offense is one of the more complicated positions. Would you say that you found that to be true, and what do you think he means by that? How's that played out for you so far in your career with here?
Yeah, I mean, yeah, it is. You know, it's always a tough position, and a lot of offenses just from the, you know, the different things they ask of you to do in the position. But here, like Coach said, it was a kind of a different level taken to it with some of the things we had to learn in the offense. Last year was, you know, it took some used to getting to. Took time to get used to, but year two, it slowed down for everyone in our room. We were helping Gronk, you know, trying to make the simple for him and easy ways to kind of remember how to get used to the calls or whatever. But it's just different things that they ask of us to do in this offense at the tight end position that you may not have done in the past. But year two, like I said, it's a lot simpler. It makes a lot more sense. And now it's all making sense to all of us in the room.
What's been the biggest thing when you look back at your tape from last season and say, I need to improve in this area moving forward now heading into 2020? What's been that thing that you've really tried to focus on?
I really honestly just want to improve in the run game. You know, as far as I've always been since college, I took pride in the run game. You know, coming from Alabama, we ran the ball a lot last year. It was just more about my footwork and stuff. I took a step back in that. But, you know, once I started focusing more on that in the run game, footwork and all the other stuff, the effort is always going to be there. The passing game, I never was too worried about that. Just got to make some plays in that aspect of the game. But for me, it was just the footwork in the run game this all season. And, you know, working on it as we speak now.
All right, next up is Jenna Lane.
OJ, I want to say it was the first pass play of practice today when you guys went offense versus defense, and Brady hit that deep shot to Scotty Miller. What did that do for you guys in terms of energy level and excitement?
Yeah, it was huge. You know, those are plays and opportunities that we always stress we got to execute on those plays, because sometimes, obviously in real football, you won't get those shots often or too many times. Once it's there, you got to take advantage of it, and it was the time we did. Scotty made a great play on the ball. Tom gave him a great pass. So those are just big plays we need, and our offense, we feed off of those, and it was really exciting to see that happen early in practice.
Next is Zach Blobner.
I just want to talk to you about expectations, both personally and for the team. Obviously, the Super Bowl expected to be set to be in Tampa Bay for this season. Is that something that you feel the team is really embracing as far as having the goal to make it to that game and the expectations surrounding it? And then do you have any personal goals or numbers that you're trying to hit this season?
Yeah, absolutely. You know, I think we all play the game for the ultimate reason is to win the world championship. We definitely have the talent in the room to do it. We all just have to put it together and stay focused for however many weeks of the season that it takes to get it done. You know, as far as me, you know, the only thing for me is just to go out there and play with 100% effort every week. And, you know, when I do that and play smart football and do my assignment and play at a high level and play fast, I make plays. You know, I've always done that in the past. It's on film. So once I get back to being myself and doing that, everything else will take care of itself.
Our next question is going to come from Alex Fleming.
Between you, Gronk, and Cameron Brait, the formations that you guys are going to run, what has Gronk taught you so far his time here, and how explosive can the tight end position be for Tampa Bay this year?
You know, there's a lot of things, you know, as far as just like little nicks and different ways to get open that, you know, I've kind of just picked up on Gronk's from his game, as far as like in the route running game, as you know, just some little things he used, different techniques, you know, and us as a whole, we have opportunity to be special. We have a group, man, of guys in the room. We're all willing to be willing to learn every day from each other, learn from our coach. B.A. and Byron are doing a great job of putting plays in for us to get open in one-on-one situations or whatever it may be. And I think everyone in the room is going to try to take advantage of that. And, you know, when all three of us on the field, it's going to be a hard time to try to stop all of that. So, like I said, once our opportunities come, we have to make the most of it and make it count.
All right, and our last one is going to come from Josh Allen.
How has Tom Brady really commanded this offense, and how has that changed in years past that you've noticed with the quarterbacks you played with?
You know, when he speaks, everyone listens. That's the type of leadership ability that he has. And like I said, he does a lot of coaching. And the thing about it is he coaches up everyone at one time. You know, he likes certain routes ran in certain ways. And, you know, when guys can listen and we can get the job done and stay on the same page that he's on, you know, he can trust to make that throw, you know, make a throw that he may not see it 100% clear, but he should expect you to be in the position that he's always been telling us about over and over again. And I think when he does that, it sticks with you. It gets in the head of all the receivers and tight ends, and we're always on the same page. And that's just a different type of leadership that I see from Tom.